Hello children, today we will learn shifting of decimal point. Shifting of decimal point in multiplication and division. But before that, you know that we always start a lesson with one moral value. And today's moral value is never say lies. And never be rude to others. Always speak the truth and be kind. This value you will learn more better. You will understand more better if you read class 4 English textbook of NCERT in that last lesson, Pinocchio. Children, I am going to make the video of that lesson also. So please see my videos. Get moral values along with the subject. So children, let us begin with shifting of decimal point. Now here you see, there are two types, or you can say two operations, multiplication and division. Now if you see the sum 2, 4, 5 multiplied by 100. See children, in the last video also I told you, if you cannot see any decimal point, you should consider the decimal point to be at the end. Now here, some children, not all, but some children, what they do, they just start multiplication. But children, we have to learn this. Now there are two zeros and there is one. You know, with one, any number multiplied by 1 gives you the number itself. We have learned this. This is identity of 1. And identity of 0 is any number multiplied by 0 is 0. So these two identities, any number multiplied by 1 is number itself, and any number multiplied by 0 is 0. This you have to keep it in your mind better. Now here with 1. So 245 ones are 245. And these two zeros we need not to multiply. In multiplication, what we have to do is, you know, the decimal point, if it is not there, consider it to be at the end and shift the two decimal place. Now there are no digits, so you can put here two zeros and shift the decimal point of here. So the answer will be 24500. We will take many more examples, children. Now we will take an example of, suppose it is 340.86 multiplied by 10. Now here there is 1. So this number multiplied by 1 will give the number itself. There is only 1 zero. So what we have to do is shift the decimal point. And shift the decimal point to the right. See children, learn this. In multiplication, we shift the decimal point to the right, and in division, we shift the decimal point to the left. So here we are talking only about multiplication today. So shift the decimal point to the right only by one digit. Why one digit? Because there is only one zero. So you here it, the answer will be 3408.6. In previous time, there was one complete topic on this. But now in textbooks, there is no such topic. So this, you have to learn it on your own. That is why I am making this video. Please subscribe and share my video and like my video so that you will understand these simple tricks. Now we can take many more examples. Now suppose we will take 421.89 multiplied by, now we will take, instead of 1 we can take 2. Now you know multiplication by 2 is very easy. Don't take this 0, just you underline this 0. And for this 0, what you will do, you will shift the decimal point to the right by 1 digit, because there is only 1 0. So it is 4218.9. And this 2 is remaining, so here you can multiply by 2. Simple, 2 9s are 18, 1 carry 2 is 16, 1 17. Now this decimal point will come over here. Carry over 1, 2, 1 is 2 plus 1, 3, 2, 2 is 4, 2, 4 is 8. See, it becomes very simple. Children, if you go on multiplying by zeros, the answer may become wrong. In school, we are seeing many children doing wrong sums only because they don't know this simple magic of shifting of decimal point. We will take many more examples, children. Learn this. It is very, very useful. Suppose the number is 429.68 multiplied by, now we will take instead of 1 0, we will take 3 zeros. So you have to shift how many digits? 3 digits. Shifting of decimal point coincides with the number of zeros. As many zeros, that many digits shifting. So here, shifting of 3 digits. Now there are only 2 digits, 0.68. So what we have to do, you have to make 3. So for making 3, you can put 1 0 here. Always on the right, children, please remember, in multiplication, right. So the answer will be 429.680. I hope you have understood this shifting of decimal point. If there is no decimal point, consider the decimal point at the end and see the number of zeros. Okay, children? Now, but the thing is, the zeros should be at the end by which you are multiplying. If it is in between, then you cannot shift. Now, we will take sums for practice. I will give you, as usual, in all my videos, I give you 5 sums so that you can solve the sums now only at the same time and do the practice. For this, I told you, you copy down the sums, pause the video for some time and then check your answer. So the first sum is 413.98 multiplied by 10. Second sum is 361 multiplied by 100. Third sum is 4532.8 multiplied by 100. Fourth sum is 621 multiplied by 1000. And fifth sum is 4.28 multiplied by 100. Now here, you can pause the video here, do the sums and check the answers. Till then, I will write the answers. So 10 means shifting by 1 point to the right side. Again, I am telling you, right side. So 14139.8. Now here there is no decimal point. So consider decimal point at the end. So 361, shifting of 2 decimals means 00. Here again there is only 1 decimal point here. But the zeros are 2. So how many places? You have to shift 2 places. So what you have to do? You have to add 1 0 here. See here. So the answer will be 80. Here there is no decimal point, so consider it to be at the end. And then what you have to do, 6, 2, 1, shifting of 3 digits means you are putting 3 zeros. And here again there are 2 decimal points and 2 zeros. So shifting is like this. So the answer will be 428. I hope, children, you got all the answers correct. This is very simple, children, very simple. But the thing is, you have to know this. You have to understand this. I hope you are liking my videos and you are learning a lot from them. Children, learning is important. By anywhere, anytime, learning is important. And I hope you will learn more and more. Become good in maths. Love maths. So be healthy. Stay fit. God bless you all.